Okay, good day to our grade 7 students. In this video lesson, we are going to tackle the comparison between electromagnetic and mechanical wave. The title, Mechanical versus Electromagnetic Waves. So, how do waves propagate? The objective in this activity, you will differentiate between mechanical waves and electromagnetic waves. So, the time allotted is 30 minutes. Materials, defined things in our activity 1, yung dalawang video lesson na pinag-upload ko po. Chart of the electromagnetic spectrum. What are mechanical waves? When you created waves using a rope in activity 1 part A, you were able to observe a moving pattern. In this case, the medium of wave propagation is the rope. So in activity 1 part B, what is the medium of wave propagation? Yun, kung titingnan po natin dito sa video, alin po ang naging medium? Okay, the answer is coil spring. In activity 1 part C, what is the medium of wave propagation? Tingnan natin. Alin po? Okay, correct, water. That is the medium. Kung napapansin po natin, pag sinabi pong mechanical waves, may daanan or may medium in order the wave to propagate. The waves that you have created in activity 1 all require a medium for wave propagation. They are called mechanical waves. So how can you generate mechanical waves? Or they can be generated by vibrating a medium. A medium is required because vibrating particles are needed for the wave to travel. So pag sinabi nating medium, ito po yung magiging daanan niya in order the wave to propagate. Kaya dito sa rope, rope is the medium of the wave propagation. So, all three kinds of waves, transverse, yung sa lubid, longitudinal, yung sa spring, and surface, dun sa tubig, are sent out by an earthquake, and it can be detected many thousands of kilometers away if the quake is a major one. So, what do you think is the source of earthquake waves? So, earthquake waves are caused by vibration due to colliding tectonic plates. Hindi lang colliding po, that can be either be, o yung tatlong plates po, tatlong klaseng plates sa grade 10 discussion, yung tinatawag na converging, diverging, and transform fault boundary. So, what is the medium of propagation of earthquake waves? Of course, saan ba dumaan ang earthquake? Sa Earth. So, what are electromagnetic waves? Ayun, pansinin natin, balikan natin, pag sinabing mechanical waves, it requires medium. Mechanical waves, it requires medium to transmit. So, what are electromagnetic waves? The energy from the sun reaches the Earth through electromagnetic waves. Kung nagtataka tayo, yung init ng sun nakakarating sa atin, even may dinadaanan siyang mga vacuum. Pag sinabing vacuum po, that is empty space ito. Thus, they can pass through empty space. Kaya ang electromagnetic waves requires no material medium for their passage. Kahit blanco, kahit empty space or vacuum, it can transmit or it can propagate. Yun po ang kaibahan ng electromagnetic wave. Ayan. Dito po sa figure na to, ito yung pito na member ng electromagnetic wave spectrum family. We have the radio wave, we have the infrared, visible light, ultraviolet, x-ray, and gamma rays. So, yan po yung sagot dito sa pito. So, kung titignan natin, the electromagnetic spectrum shows the various type of electromagnetic waves, the range of their frequencies and wavelength. The wave speed of all electromagnetic waves is the same, equal to the speed of light, which is approximately equal to 300 million meter per second. So, itong speed po na ito, kung i-convert natin yan sa scientific notation, that is 3 times 10 raised to 8 meter per second. So, yung pong exponent niya doon sa power of 10 is 8. So, lahat po ng member ng electromagnetic spectrum family, same ang kanilang speed with the speed of light. So, examine the electromagnetic spectrum. Describe the relationship between frequency and wavelength of each electromagnetic wave. So, balikan po natin yung isang picture kanina ito. Kung papansin natin, itong gamma ray ang pinakamataas ang frequency pero pinakamaikli ang wavelength. Ang radio wave naman ang pinakamahaba ang wavelength pero pinakamababa ang frequency. Meaning, mula dito sa radio wave, itong lowest frequency, gamma ray has the highest frequency. Among electromagnetic waves, the higher the frequency, the shorter the wavelength. So, habang umiikli pala yung wavelength po, tumataas ang frequency. So, yung mahaba ang wavelength, yun ang mababa ang frequency. So, draw waves to represent each electromagnetic wave. Your illustration must represent the wavelength of a wave relative to the others. For instance, gamma rays have a very small wavelength compared to the other waves in the spectrum. So, kagaya na sinabi ko kanina, gamma rays has the highest frequency but has the shortest wavelength. Kaya siksikan, pinong-pino. So, yung iba, ayan, magiging itsura niyan. So, radio wave, pinakamahaba na ang wavelength, meaning pinakamababa ang frequency. At may kinalaman din po yan sa energy. The higher the energy, the higher the frequency. So, kung titingnan natin, alin ang pinakamataas ang energy? Siyempre, yung mataas ang frequency. gamma ray. At yun din po ang maikli ang wavelength. The sun is an important source of ultraviolet waves, which is the main source of sunburn. So, gumagamit po tayo ng sunscreen lotion, yung tinatawag natin na may SPF. Ang ibig sabihin pala po, no, is solar protection factor. Karaniwan po, SPF 50 pataas. So, why are UV rays harmful to the skin compared to visible light? So, yun. Ang mas mataas po, syempre, ang kanyang frequency ng UV ray compared sa visible light. So, compare the frequency and energy carried by UV waves to that of visible light. Ayan. UV waves have higher energy and frequency compared to visible light. Yun, kung titignan po natin dito, so ito yung gamma, pinakamaiklang wavelength, pero pinakamataas ang frequency and pinakamataas ang energy. At itong radio wave, ang pinakamababa ang frequency, pinakamababa ang energy, and pinakamahaba naman ang kanyang wavelength. But the speed of these members of the spectrum family are all the same with the speed of light, or 3 times 10 raised to 8 meter per second. So for summary, mechanical waves like sound, water waves, earthquake waves, and waves in a stretch string propagation through a medium. May daan ng medium. While electromagnetic waves such as radio waves, visible light, and gamma do not require a material medium for their passage. Kaya tanda natin, kahit walang daanan, dadaan ang electromagnetic wave. So the activities that you have performed are all about wave motion or the propagation of a pattern caused by a vibration. Waves transport energy from one place to another, thus they can set objects into motion. Tanda natin, wave is an energy carrier. Ang bit-bit niya, ang pasahero niya is energy ng wave. So, kung ang wave ay may bit-bit na energy, it can cause motion in an object. So, what happens when waves pass by? So, in activity 1, introduce you to transverse waves, longitudinal and surface waves. You observe the motion of a segment of the material through which the wave travels. Ayan, transverse waves occur when the individual particles or segments of a medium vibrate from one side to side perpendicular to the direction in which the waves travel. Longitudinal waves occur when the individual particles of a medium vibrate back and forth in the direction in which the waves travel. Parang yung sa coil spring. So, the motion of water molecules on the surface of deep water in which a wave is propagating is a combination of transverse and longitudinal displacement, with the result that molecules at the surface move in nearly circular path. Each molecule is displaced both horizontally and vertically from its normal position. So, while energy is transported by virtue of the moving pattern, it is important to remember that there is not in net transport of matter in wave motion. The particles vibrate about a normal position and do not undergo a net motion. So, how can you describe waves? So, in activity 2, you have encountered the important terms and quantities used to describe periodic waves. So, we have the crest and trough. Pag sinabing crest, highest part, trough, lowest part of the wave. So, the amplitude or height of wave is a maximum displacement of a particle of the medium on either side of its normal position when the wave passes. So, sinabi natin yung amplitude, yung height. Ang sukatan po niyan from equilibrium position to the highest point of the wave or to the lowest point of the wave. So, number 3, the frequency of periodic waves is the number of waves that pass a particular point for every 1 second, while the wavelength is the distance between adjacent crests or troughs. So, the period is the time required for one complete wave to pass a particular point. So, the speed of the wave refers to the distance the wave travels per unit time. It is related to the frequency of the wave and wavelength through the following equation. Ayan. Wave speed. So, frequency times wavelength. Yan po yung pinaka-formula. So, or V is equals to F times lambda. Ang symbol po ng wavelength is lambda. So, how do waves propagate? Finally, activity 3 prompted you to distinguish between mechanical and electromagnetic waves. So, in mechanical waves, some physical medium is being disturbed for the wave to propagate. A wave traveling on a string would not exist without the string. A sound waves could not travel through air if there were no air molecules. With mechanical waves, what we interpret as a wave corresponds to the propagation of a disturbance through a medium. On the other hand, electromagnetic waves do not require medium to propagate. Some examples of EM waves are visible light, radio waves, television signals, and X-ray.